Greetings from sunny South Texas. How are y'all doing today? Oh man, so it's good to be back on a few videos again. And I need love. That's this song. I don't know if y'all can hear it. I'm happy today, y'all, because Brother Swag, Swag Duh, over on YouTube, man. If you don't know who he is, you go check him out. Sent me I was actually the winner of his prize pack for his 100 subscribers. And by this time, he's probably already at 200-300 subscribers at this point. Let's be honest. The guy is cool. So let's open up these books, y'all. Let's see what brings a smile to everybody's face, all of our faces. And let's open this up and let's check out what Swag got us. Whatever. What we're going to do is we're going to open up and we'll show you the covers. Then we're going to put them on the table and take a nice little stroll through them. All right. So here we go. All right. How y'all doing today? All right. Swag. Dude, I just want to say before I start opening these, man, it is so cool watching your videos. It's fun for me because I get to see the enjoyment that when you're going through the boxes that you get from Rob's Claim Sales or from your LCS, things like that. It's just so nice, man, to see that your face light up, all the joy that you have. And then that's what it's all about, brother. It's all about having fun. And now you're joining us on Saturday mornings. Collect what you love, collect what you like, and love what you collect, man. Right? That's what it's about. So let's take a look at these. I just wanted to open them on camera. I need love. Shout out to everybody out there today. Here we go. What we got right here, Swag? What we got right here? Oh, man. We got us a Funko Pop. Ooh, look at this. Goonies. Dang. Swag. Let me tell you about this movie, brother. Goonies. Data, right? That's how you say his name. Had the coolest Nikes. I remember watching that movie. I remember those black Nikes with the silver swoosh. Dude, I wanted those Nikes. I wanted all the little gadgets that he had. Y'all look at that. Brother, this is my first Funko Pop, man. God. With the overcoat. Dude, that, and it's got the little... Oh, hold on, Swag. I got to put my glasses on, man. He's got the little punching bag and everything. Oh, man. I know you're supposed to keep these in the box and display them, but... Once I get all this situated around here, I'm making a little progress on my room. But once I get it all situated, brother, I'm going to have this display proud. That I don't know how you knew, because this is an awesome movie. And you knew this guy right here, Data. Oh, man. Thank you, Swag. Thank you. Oh, man. Right off the bat, bro. What we got here? Man, Swag, you packed some good packing over here, man. Okay, so we got the books right here. We got this going on right here. All right, so let's check out some books, y'all. Let's check out some books. Let me put this over here. I can't believe that, man. That is awesome. Does he have the Nike? Yeah, he's got some. He's rocking those kicks. Oh, you can't. Nike get after you, put them, but. Oh, man, that is so cool. I cannot. That is so cool. All right, let's check out the books. Now, Swag did show these on the channel. He said, this is what you're going to be getting. But, and that was just cool to win, man. I wasn't expecting. Oh, he sent over this. And he's got a little note for me here. Swag, I'm not going to read it on camera. I'm going to read it, though, all right? Enjoy the book. Yeah. And just to let y'all see, when Swag puts, I saw him do this on Triple C's letters. He puts little stickers. That's pretty cool, brother. And yes, man, enjoy the surprise. I did enjoy the surprise. And he asked me, what am I snacking on? I ain't snacking on nothing right now, Swag. I done gained 5-15 pounds watching your videos. Every time I watch your videos, I get hungry. I wonder why. All right, let's check out these books. Let's check them out. Oh, shoot. All right, he sent over some stickers. Free comic book day. Oh, yeah, that's cool. And Swag's got a nice comic shop that he goes to. I mean, I think he said he gets comics 3 for $1. Nice. Look at that one. That one's cool. You gotta love me, baby. I don't know if y'all can hear the music. I can hear the music. Let's see. Oh, shoot, yeah. Look at that one. When Captain America throws his mighty shield. Y'all look that one up. All right, then we've got Avenger sticker. Yeah, these are going to look good on some of these boxes once I get them all situated, right? All right, let's get down to it. Here we go. Like I said, I'm going to show the covers, and then I won't put these under the on the table, man. Let's take a look at them together. Let's share this together. I know Razor wanted this one. He said that I sent, he told, Shut up. Yeah, here we go. Right off the bat, man, we've got Mighty Mouse. Swag. Between the Funko Pop bringing back memories, Mighty Mouse, a lot of memories, man. If you would indulge me, let me tell you a story, man. When we was kids, we would go over to the Kmart, and they had this machine where you could sit down, plop in a quarter, and they would show you a real short cartoon. And I don't know if anybody remembers those well, not vending machines, but they're not, I don't know if you call them arcade machine, but I used to watch Mighty Mouse cartoons in those machines. That's cool. Oh, shoot. Look on the back here. Look on the back. Amazing Spider-Man 369. And we've got Electro on the cover. The Green Goblin featuring, what does it say on the bottom? Plus the Green Goblin. Spider Slayers. Let me tell you, Swag. Electro. Growing up, reading comic books in the late 70s, early 80s. Yeah, Electro was cool. And then later on, a little bit later in the, I guess, 83, 82, the Spider-Man cartoons. That was one of our favorites, man. We, in our house, when we were watching wrestling, we were always going for the bad guys. During the movies, yeah. So the villains were always cool to us, man. So thank you, Swag. I can't wait to open these up. Okay, then we got to take these off nice and carefully. Oh, shoot. I wonder who won that race. We've got Batman number 21. Turn that down a little bit. Batman number 21. Now, don't tell me Batman's trying to foot race the Flash. It ain't gonna happen, right? And then on the back here, I guess when we open these up, I'll know who this is, man. But that is cool, man. I like the colors on that. That pops. I'll find out who that is, Swag. Like I said, man, when I'm watching your videos, brother, and you show some of the newer books, I'm like, whoa, I didn't know that was out there. I didn't know this book was out there. I didn't know about this one. So I'm learning a lot from you, Swag. I'm learning to kind of keep my eyes open for some of these books that I would normally pass by, man. Superboy, number 10. Heck yeah. This is during the... And I've been reading more 90s Superman in the last few months. And I know that this is a clone of Superman, right? And then there was this thing, but we'll get into it when I start flipping through it. I've read a few of these, and I'm happy to have this one. Superboy number 10. All right, let's see what else we got here. Super Dinosaurs, number 4. Oh, man. This is what I'm talking about, Swag. I let some of this stuff pass me by, man. And I shouldn't. I need to be more receptive to newer books. So we're gonna open this one up, see what's going on in here, right? And I know you showed these on your channel, but like you said in your video, man, getting the books in hand, it makes them so much better, right? Oh, shoot. I like the back cover of this one. What is it? Ooh, swag. Yes. Yes. Black Hammer. Dude, I'm going to turn up the music on this one just a little bit. Do you guys play love songs for your comic books like I do? Oh, man. Dude, swag. I have been so interested in this title. And I know it has different, you know, it's got different iterations and things like that. But I've never picked one up. And now I have one, dude. Thank you. That is so cool. Here's the back cover of it. Yeah, something about this. I've seen covers where they're depicting scenes from World War II or sci-fi. That is so cool, man. Oh, wow. Swag. Swag. The Scorch. Again, look at this. Y'all, look at this cover. Look at that. Swag, I'm sitting across right now from a box of independent books that I'm going through. And the ones that I'm keeping are very similar to this. You've got your swords. You've got, shout out to Higgy Pop, you got the wings going on there too, man, right? Dude, this one is looks cool. And I'm not going to open it yet. We're going to put it on the table and check them out. And the hits keep coming, y'all. Here we go. Let's see what this one is. He's got him face down. The Boogeyman. Boogeyman, what issue is this? Number 5 from a Blaze Comics. Look at that. Swag, in Spanish, we call this El Cucuy. The Boogeyman, El Cucuy is the same thing. It scares the kids, man. You act up, the Boogeyman's going to get you. The Cucuy's going to get you. Ah, oh, dude, cannot wait to open these up. Oh, Razor. Cover your eyes, Razor. This is the one, Razor. Let me tell you about this one. Let me tell you about, oh, let's do this one first. I've opened up Swag. Dude. Okay, Angry Birds. I remember playing that a few years ago on my phone. But I'll tell you right now, Swag, I don't do video games, even though I was brought up right perfect for video games because that's when they were hitting, you know, they were coming out with home consoles, things like that. I could never, well, number one, we could never afford them. But my friends, you know, they were the ruthless players. You start playing them, they just beat you real quick and go and get next one. So I never got into them, man, but comic books were my jam, right? But look at Angry Birds with who? Other than Dick Tracy on the cover. That is, I just now see it right now, the little Angry Bird with a fedora on. Hey, Swag, this is nice, dude. This is so cool, brother. And those other ones, yeah, I remember getting to certain stages and then, yeah, I couldn't pass it. But oh well, the video games are not, but this is cool. But Razor, now Razor Comics, Ray. Turn around, do something, brother, because this is the one that you wanted. Rick and Morty, what is this? Number one, wow. Rick and Morty, number one. All right, Swag, let me tell you something about Rick and Morty. I remember my nephews were over one day, and they're like, Uncle Mike, you got to check this out. What is it? Rick and Morty. I watched an episode or two. It was fun, dude. It was fun. And then when I saw that this was one of the prizes, I was like, damn, that would be cool to get. Well, here I am. I've got it. So I know just a little bit after watching those couple of episodes that I watched. Yeah. So I'm excited about looking at getting this one. Yeah, Rick and Morty, man. This may shock a few people, but yeah, when it comes to watching things, I'm the guy that's watching all the free movies with no plot, just old dump. That's what I'm watching. And it takes other people to introduce me to cool stuff like Rick and Morty. And here's another confession to all y'all out there. I don't think I've ever watched one episode of SpongeBob. There, I said it. But, dang, I'm going to pause the video right now. We're going to flip the camera around and let's take a look at what these books look like on the inside. All right, we'll be right back. I don't know, Swag. I still can't get over this, dude. you know, watching that movie, everybody loved, you know, the main characters, I guess, Chunk and those guys. But this dude right here, man, I wanted so bad to go home and make gadgets and stuff like that. That is so cool. All right, y'all, let's take a look at some of these books sent over by Swag Duh. And we're going to be using one of these art pieces that I created. All right, this is pour paint. This is what you call it. It's got a bunch of little... And then I found this picture of... they had them. I said, okay, we'll put that on there. But anyway, let's take a look at the real beauty, the real artwork. We're going to start off just the way I put them down. Amazing Spider-Man, number 369. This is from 1992, if I'm not mistaken. All right, so let's just do a quick little flip through. Now, Swag, I had stopped collecting comics during this time. And, yeah, man. So, I mean, Spider-Man, again, I mean, what kid didn't like Spider-Man growing up? Oh, let's see who's doing the work on this one real quick. All right, so we've got David Michelinie, if I'm saying that correct, y'all, as a writer, and Mark Bagley doing the pencils. All right. Let's go ahead and shout out the inker, Randy Emberlin, as well. All right, so we got Amazing Spider-Man. And this looks cool, man. This looks super cool, right? Yeah, so it's good to get some of these from the 90s, from that time period that I missed, man. So I do appreciate it. Oh, shoot, look at that. Now, I've been going through and scooping up... Ghost Rider whenever I see him. Look at that. That's sweet right there. Now, I do know the name Mark Bagley from going through some of these books from back then. This looks like fun, dude. This looks like fun. Oh, yeah. And it's still on that old school stock. Oh, wow. You got a backup story, too, man. J.M. DeMatteis. Hey, shout out to Psychotronic. And Todd Smith is a pencil on this one. I believe those are the Guardians, if I'm not mistaken. Right? Look at that. All right. Thank you, Swag. Thank you, Swag. Let's put this one to the side here. All right, let's open up. Next one. Let's take a look at Mighty Mouse. Oh, man. Yeah, Swag. So, yeah, growing up, watching those cartoons at the store, man, right? They had a babysitter for us, a little cartoon machine. Oh, man, look at that. And, of course, watching these cartoons on TV, right? Sweet, man. And this is what I'm talking about, Swag. You've introduced me to taking another look at some of these new books. Look at that. Can't wait to read this one because... Again, this is one of those characters that whenever I see it, man, no matter what it is, I'm going to try to get it. And I know I missed one on the claim sale. Yeah. Yeah. And then here's another cool thing, man. Now I get to see some of the newer ads, some of these books, Garfield, right? I like Heathcliff, and I got a few of those books. But... Oh, we got Mighty Mouse in the suit. What's going on there? Betty Boop. All right. Oh, let me go back because I know someone. But no, Swag, this is awesome, brother. Thank you. There you go. What issue is that? Number 3. Mighty Mouse number 3. I think you started me on another journey, Swag. Mighty Mouse in the works, buddy. Let's put that one to the side. All right, so let's open up this one, man. Let me see who this is. All right. Now, I know watching some of y'all's channels, they tell you on the back. It says War of the Realms, number 3. I had a few of these back in the day, man. I had a few of these back in the day. Battle Lines. Let's see. If y'all know who that is, let me know in the comment, man. Maybe I should. It looks like it's a mixture of different heroes. Like, I see this right here. And that, to me, that looks like Nova. But then I got all this. It might be a Super Scroll all over again. You never know. OK. Okay. Thor, Odin, Freya. Oh, yeah, dude. We got Asgard in here. Heck yeah, man. Let's see what we got here. Written by Jason Aaron, drawn by Russell Davertonman. Yeah. Y'all forgive me for the mispronunciation. Oh, yeah, dude. Check it out. Daredevil, Cap. Cap's got an axe, battle axe. What's going on with that, man? Well, he's hopefully, I think they're in Asgard. Daredevil with a sword. What's going on? Oh, dude. What? Yeah, man. Yeah. Oh, dude, that guy looks cool, whoever that is. Punisher, what? That says Punisher right there. God dang, what's going on in this one, Swag? Wow. Oh, yeah, dude. Venom, Captain Marvel. Let's see what we got over here. Nice, dude, nice. So I'm getting all the heroes in this one, man. I'm getting everybody in this one. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to be going down another rabbit hole. Midgard. Nice. I like these maps. As a big Conan reader, I like the maps, right? I like to see where Conan's at. Where is he kicking butt? Oh, wow. Dang. That's pretty cool, man. That's pretty cool. Riding a Pegasus. Star Wars. Heck yeah, Swag. I'll be reading these pretty soon, man. Heck yeah. Let's see what we've got next. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Let's see. Batman and the Flash. All right. I want to know, why are they racing? Why is Flash even entertaining this idea, right? I don't know Batman to be a fast runner unless something happened in recent times, right? One of these days, I'll show the Superman Flash race that I have. I've got that one. We got Watchmen going on over here, right? And Batman's swag. Batman is always cool, man, no matter what. Getting a Batman comic is a good day. And I've got Spider-Man. I got Mighty Mouse. I got heck yeah, dude. Oh, shoot, yeah. I don't know if Razor might have this one. Sorry, Razor. It's mine, brother. Oh, yeah. That is cool, man. Why are they fighting? Well, that's Yellow Flash. Okay. That's why they're fighting. Nice. Let me do one more here. Yeah, Swag. So when I got back into buying books frequently, it was back in 2008. And I was picking up some stuff, man. But, you know, I always go to the back issues and do that. But I had plenty of these, brother. So, yeah, I was back. I think I was kind of out of it during Rebirth. I don't know, man. I can't remember, to be honest with you. But that is pretty dang cool, man. All right, let's stack it up over here nice and pretty. Let's go to the next one. I hope y'all are enjoying these little flip-throughs, right? Let's see. We got the Superboy. And Swag, I think this one's going to go in nice and sweet with the ones I've been reading, right? Yeah, because I know that he's a clone. At least I'm pretty sure that he's a clone in this one. And then there for a while, he wanted to be the Superman. And then, of course, the Superman came back after being dead. The Hilo Monster. Ooh, the Hilo Monster. Humberto Ramos. Hey, all right. Nice. Heck yeah, brother. That is nice. Yeah, so I know, Swag, you're getting introduced to all these new titles from back when. I'm doing the same thing, brother. I'm doing the same thing. Double Dragon. See, Swag, that's back when I was around for Atari and all that. And then as I got a little bit older, people were playing these types of games, these Double Dragons and all that. Yeah, I couldn't hang on any of those. I never got into that, man. Man, look at that. Yeah, I'm a fan of Ramos's art. Nice, brother, nice. Good stack to read, man. Good stack to read over here. All right, here we go. something totally new to me, Super Dinosaurs. It's written by Robert Kirkman. I can see, whoa, Swag, you gave me something from your Kirkman collection? I just now noticed that, man. Nice, dude. Wow, okay. That is something, dude. All right, so look at these cool dinosaurs, man. All right, I'm gonna find out who that kid is, what his connection is to these dinosaurs. Nice. Yeah, Swag, thank you. Introducing me to something new. Look, I mean, yeah, that is cool, dude. You're talking to a guy that grew up on Godzilla movies. We used to get these Japanese TV shows, man, back in the day. They were the precursor to Power Rangers, right? Ultraman was the one I remember. Would never miss that one. Then we used to have some cool anime for back in the day. Oh, we got power outage. That's all right. We're still going strong here. Yeah, man. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you, Swag, introducing me to some of this. Oh, shoot. Look at that. Yeah. I dig it, brother. That is nice. Super Dinosaur number 4. I want to know what is this, dude? What is this? And it's a Kirkman, straight from your collection, brother. Thank you. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah. Okay. Black Hammer. Dude, like I said, I've been wanting this one. I've been wanting to pick up this series, but I never knew where to jump in on it. But I got my jumping in point now. Let's see. We've got Chip Zdarsky. Shout out to Higgy Pop. And Johnny, art by Johnny Christmas. What? That's a cool name. Hey, mama, why don't you name me Johnny Christmas? Color art by Dave Stewart. Oh, dude, yeah. Okay, here we go. Uncle Slam is the title to this story. Whoa. All right. And I'm definitely going to do my research into what this is, because I know, I'm just taking a shot here. I think Black Hammer is several villain heroes are in the storyline, I think, if I'm just gauging off of what I've seen for covers. Yeah, dude. I don't want to look at too much, man. I want a surprise here. Nice. Got some boxing in there. There you go, Swag. There you go. Oh, shoot. Shout out to Aaron, dude. Check out those eyeballs, man. All right. I got to buy that one. I got to get into this series. You got these people chilling on some eyeballs here. Yeah. Thank you, Swag. Thank you. My wife doesn't thank you because I'm going to be spending more money on these books. But that is a beautiful cover, man. Shout out to Johnny Christmas. Okay. Here we go. Scorched, another one, dude. That, just the cover alone, man. That is sweet. Let's see what we got here, man. Let's see what we got here. This is a heavy cardstock, man. You're going to make my other books jealous, Swag. Look at here. Dang, okay, that is some nice art. Who's doing this one? Sean Lewis is doing the script. Steven Segovia. Okay. I say that name like I know who it is, but look, this is not... I say it like that because I am impressed with just the first page. Whoa. All right. Thank you, Swag. Dang. All right, getting all shut up there. Look at that art, y'all. That is nice. Oh, is this a Spawn book, dude? Is that... I see Spawn right there. Is this a Spawn book? Wow. Swag. This is my first Spawn book ever. Wow, dude. All right. Shout out to Will, a couple comics. Wow. Oh, and it's a Gunslinger, dude. What am I looking at here, man? All right. Gunslinger. Oh, Swag, thank you. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. Okay, let me go back just one more. Let's do one more. Yeah, Swag. Dude. Okay. I'm putting pieces together over here. Thank you. Ah, let's look at El Cucuy. The Boogeyman. The Boogeyman. Let's see. Let's open it up. Let's open. Shout out to my uncle who taught us when we were kids. You don't just tear open a book. You got to palm it like this. You got to put in your hand. And you got to like that, right? Doing that. So we've got Matthew Salvia as the writer and artist DeJet. Right? That's what I'm reading right there. Okay, look at this art, dude. Let's see what we got here. Uh-oh. Already pulling at the heartstrings on this one. The book, not the song. Well, the song too. Ah, dude, I like scenes like this where the dude's chilling in his study. Oh man, this looks, dude, Swag. I like this, man. That right there. Right there. That brought me in more. Right there. Whatever's going on, I'm digging it. Digging it, baby. Nice, dude. Wow. All right, Swag. I'm hooked, brother. I'm hooked. So far, man, these are awesome. Which I knew they would be, but god dang, dude. Yeah. I need to keep an eye out for some of these, man. I'm missing the boat on some of these, y'all. Boogeyman. And if y'all get another close-up of the Boogeyman, that dude looks cool. All right, all right. And now, Razor. Well, let's look at Angry Birds. I got to see Dick Tracy on Angry Birds right here. Angry Birds, what did we say this was? Number 4. Yeah, look at that. Boom, pop right there. Bam, just pops open to you right there. So we've got different creators. We've got different artists going on over here. And I bet you I'm going to get a kick out of this, dude. Like a lot of us, dude, we like our comics. We like certain things, but we're all kids at heart, right? And any cartoon book just brings a smile to our face because this book is going to remind you of something else growing. For me, that is. Growing up. Yep. Dude, this game. Oh, man. I remember one day I was sitting there and I look up and I was like, damn, I spent like 5 hours playing this game. I need to. not even snacking on anything. And by the time everybody, you know, we start saying, oh, this, because I'll read the comments. I'm like, dang, now I'm hungry. But yeah, Swag, thank you. Thank you for giving me books like this that were good connections for me growing up. And thank you for all the newer things that have been introduced to me. I really appreciate it, sir. And you know what, bro? I'm just gonna say this, man. You're gonna do a lot, brother Swag. You've got this this charisma about you. You got this good, sweet soul, Swag. That's what I dig about your channel, brother. And I just wanted to say thank you and nothing but continued success for you, man. So with that, everybody, I will say thank you. I appreciate everybody watching. And yeah, go check out Swag. Swag duh. All right. Man, y'all take care. And top to bottom, left to right, this reading stuff is out of sight. There's my final. Y'all take care now.